outside Japan's exclusive economic zone. Japan says that they are looking into the type of missiles fired at around 1:47 a.m. local time, with the second one falling some 6 minutes later. Possibilities of a submarine-launched ballistic missiles are too being taken into consideration. The South Korean military feels the latest missile launches by its neighbor are a serious provocation and harms peace. Seoul believes that the missiles were launched from the Bancheon city, located on the east coast of North Korea. South Korea says that the uptick in North Korea's missile launches signals that it is closer than ever to resuming nuclear testing for the first time since 2017. Preparations observed at its test site for months now. The U.S. military says it is closely consulting with allies and partners calling the launches to engage, underlining the impact of North Korean nuclear arms and ballistic missile programs. The U.S. reiterated its commitment to protect Japan and South Korea. On Friday, Washington announced new sanctions on North Korea. Pyongyang testified a ballistic missile rather than ever before on Tuesday, sending it soaring over Japan for the first time in 5 years and prompting a warning for residents to take cover. On the other hand, North Korea, which has pursued missile and nuclear tests in defiance of United Nations sanctions, said on Saturday that its missile tests are for self-defense against direct U.S. military threats and not arms into neighboring countries and neighbors. And to talk more about this latest move by North Korea is Colonel David B. Des Rogers, a defense expert who is joining us from Maryland, United States of America. David, welcome to the program. What's your view on North Korea's firing of the ballistic missiles? Some say it is a way to provoke tensions in the region.
Yeah, that seems to be always in the background with North Korea. Another possibility is that North Korea's economy has tanked, and generally what they try to do is get the attention of the West in general, the United States in particular, in order to enter into new rounds of negotiations that will lead to concessions, most notably with other people feeding North Korea's population. I think that the leadership of North Korea seems to have calculated that the attention of the United States is diverted elsewhere, that it won't have the ability to respond militarily, and therefore this is a good time to try to extract maximum concessions. But all of this has to be viewed with the idea that North Korea is very opaque. We're not exactly sure what their motivations are, but it seems to fit in with patterns in the past.
Why do you think they're targeting Japan?
Well, Japan's a very rich country, a very close country. The most recent missile launches have been in the direction of Japan. But I think they want to get the Japanese attention as well because, you know, if you want to get a hold of the United States, we're very far away. But Japan's very close and Japan is very influential in the United States. The United States has treaty obligations to defend Japan. So it makes sense for the North Koreans to try to exert pain on the Japanese if they really want to get the U.S.'s attention.
David, do you think North Korea could be inching closer to us? Nuclear testing, and what would be the ramifications of that?
Well, they have already tested a nuclear weapon. We know that. The question is whether they can get a nuclear weapon small enough to put on one of those missiles that can be reasonably deployed. If they can, particularly if they can deploy a nuclear weapon on a submarine, then that means potentially they have the ability to strike, you know, a much broader region of the world, possibly Western of the United States. That is very, very, very significant. And if that happens, it's possible that Korea may inch to the top of the security concern displacing Russia and Ukraine.
David, lastly, the United States, South Korea, and even Japan have condemned this test. What do you think they should do next?
Yeah, that's a good question. It's really, really hard to see how North Korea can be punished in a non-military way because, you know, they're pretty much sanctioned as much as they can be sanctioned. I think that, you know, the world powers, the idea of the United Nations taking action, you know, they would have done it already if they could. that, quite frankly, they have to bolster defenses. I think that the employment of the Thad here to